Good evening, pilots, and I am back. Or maybe good afternoon or good evening. I suppose it depends on when you're watching this video. But anyway, welcome. I have been away for quite some time, and as you'll see, I am not playing Series Resurrector tonight. Instead, I've decided to try out something different from my new friend Strygon. Shout out to you, mate. This is his mod that he's put together. This is called Operation Cloak and Dagger. So here we go, Operation Cloak and Dagger. A short 6-mission campaign in which you will partake in a military campaign to defeat the Legion of Dragons. Okay, I'm not sure what to expect from this, but as Strygon says, he says that it is complete and currently working on the sequel to this, so I'll see how that goes. But in the meantime, let us start with this one. I'm always interested to try out something different, so let's see what we've got here.
A warm welcome to new recruits, to all those who have enlisted for service in the Allied Defense Force. We wish you a productive 3 years of duty. As a relatively fresh organization, we will need all the manpower we can get to ensure interstellar peace will remain for decades to come. We are an extranational authority and are under no one's hand. Through interventions and surgical strikes at 10 spots, we have prevented wars from breaking out, and we will continue to do so in the future. To fight for us means to fight for peace. This is the mission statement of all those that are here today. AGAD Administrator O'Dear Roberts, leader of the ADF.
Okay, interesting.
Recent pilot uprisings, this is a situation that concerns all of us. With the recent increase in trading between systems and the loosening of borders between nations, well, most of them, we are pretty much experiencing the same thing that has happened back then, somewhere around the 15th century. The massive rise in piracy.
Damn pirates.
Systems have lackluster or no garrisons at all. All the nations do know how to beat the Akatha up with their navies, but have got zero clue on how to defend trade fleets from pirates. More criminally minded people have become aware of that, and just like that, suddenly we get reports of captured transports, destroyed freighters, and so on. At the beginning it was every man for himself, and most attacks were rather small, carried out by only one or two fighters. But as time went on, people have grouped up. From individuals became groups, and then those groups turned into full-blown organized gangs, and those small attacks turned into large-scale, fleet-level assaults.
Wow, that's pretty interesting. One thing I just want to do quickly is I just want to turn down the music just a wee bit.
The Legion of Dragons, I'll pretend is the name is. The Legion has been a massive pain in the rear for the ADF for a while now. Formerly led by Edward Oraki Osprey, who was killed in an accident with his fighter not too long ago, it is now led by his offspring, who is so far only known by the name of the accountant.
Ooh, scary.
The Legion of Dragons has a tight grip on other, smaller gangs, acting as the top dog who gives orders to the others. Through a number of famous heists, such as the raid on the Interstellar Bank, they have acquired large numbers of funds, along with military-grade equipment during attacks on Navy assets. Reports are spotty, but they are rumored to even have a unique heavy cruiser at their disposal.
No,
they are not someone to be trifled with, but dissolving them would surely lead to a complete collapse of interstellar piracy. All that is needed is someone to get this ball rolling, and that's where we come in.
No surprise there.
The 26th Scorpions. The Scorpions are a rather recent squadron, consisting of the Wings, Razorback, Griffin, and Scorpion. We are trained in dogfighting, espionage and sabotage. The ships that are fielded by us are the Firefly-class fighters and Monstrum-class bombers. We are an anti-piracy squadron, and will therefore lead the operation that will take down the Legion of Dragons for good. Operation Cloak and Dagger.
So we're playing as counter-terrorists. Wow.
Listen up. We have an immediate situation here. On 0550, one of our infiltrators in the League of Dragons, the local pirate gang, has reported intel about an imminent attack in this system.
Okay.
The small fleet of freighters, designation hauler, is scheduled to pass through here into the Betelgeuse system. These freighters carry various goods for the stations at Betelgeuse, but Kepler Hercules is devoid of any civilization, and they're therefore defenseless. Detours are, due to the current political situation between the USU and the Expergy, not possible at this time.
Well, it is colorful, I will say that.
If our intel is correct, the pirate squadron attacking the freighters will primarily consist of Tomahawk and Type 86 class fighters. They're pretty old and in the one-on-one fight, no match against our Fireflies, but you should nonetheless not underestimate them. The League of Dragons aren't one of the strongest gangs without reason after all. We should expect them to try to disable the freighters first, instead of destroying them, so use this knowledge to your advantage and hit them while they're still equipped with their disruptor lasers.
Okay.
Unfortunately, we can only field Scorpion Wing for this mission. Razorback Wing is still occupied with the situation elsewhere in the system,
nice.
And Griffin Wing is currently undergoing repairs from their last mission. You'll be at a numerical disadvantage, so it will not be an easy mission. Use your technological advantage and your knowledge to gain an edge and win this battle. You'll be launching in 15 minutes. Check your equipment and ship data in the hangar area if necessary.
Alright, so defend the freighters from pirates. It should be easy enough. What do we got? Firefly Mark 1, space superiority. Wow, that's pretty decent. Formidable light. No missile banks. Ah. Okay. What do we got here? Low hull damage, medium shield damage, high rate of fire. Anti-armor, high hull, low shield, medium rate of fire. Anti-shield weapon, high shield damage, low hull damage. No, this is medium shield damage, so I'm gonna take these high hull damage. Yeah. Alright, well, let's see what we got. Oh, wow. It's not like that can ever be missed out in space. Alright, I like the speed. I really like the speed. Oh wow. Oh, does it auto track? Oh, that's cool. Oh, I love these ones where it auto tracks. Oh, I like that a lot. I do like that a lot. This is kind of like spawn killing, you know that. Oh well. I'll say one thing, their shields are a bit of a thing to get through initially, but once you get through those, it's... Their armor is not exactly that high on these things. Oh, hello. Oh, yeah. Typical. Run away. He should have tried to kill me, but then he got darted himself. I know I was a bit bummed about not having missiles, but I like this more. Oh yeah, baby. Quick and simple. Alright, let's get these transports over to that jump gate. Defeat the accountant. Yeah, he just ran away. Then again, card mode always kicks in at 1% health on some of these things. Don't you just love plot armor? Let's have a look at this ship. I like it. Oh yeah, it looks like they disabled it. Oh well. So we could jump out. Bye. You see, that sounded like that was building up a
Despite the early surprise attack of the pirates, you have managed to successfully prevent the destruction of any of the four freighters, and at the same time, deal heavy damage to the pirate forces. This was no easy task, but you have persevered. To this, I can only say, well done, pilot. This will most certainly show the League of Dragons that their time is up.
Well, fuck them.
While it is unknown as to why the accountant happened to be in the system as well, I'm sure we will find out in the later stages of the operation. But for now, let's focus on the next mission.
Yeah, who else do we need to destroy?
The first part of the operation requires infiltration of the enemy
the
ranks.
Fuck?
Of course, the Legion won't just let anyone in just like that. So we have to take someone else's existing identity. And our target for that is Wolf 2. First we capture his fighter, then we have the data archives to make sure no discrepancies show up. This mission here will take care of the first half. Due to the nature of this mission, you will be flying in P-776 class police fighters, equipped with the 145 Enforcer Disruptor Laser. Your only goal here is to disable Wolf 2. Once that is done, stand by for the Gladius arrival. There will most likely be multiple other wings nearby, and your ships are hopeless in a dogfight, which is why we will also deploy Razorback 1 and 2 to escort you on this mission.
Oh, that's helpful. So disable Wolf 2, wait for the Gladius. Can't change shit. Lovely. Couldn't they have picked a better weapon than this? This weapon sucks. I don't know why it has to be Wolf 2, seriously. Ah, finally, some damage. What? Oh shit, I forgot they regenerate. Oh, come on. Razor is doing absolutely no help here. Ooh, I'm gonna die soon. Man, I'm gonna fucking die at this rate. All because they give us shitty weapons to work with. Seriously, what the hell is going on here? Ah, great. That weapon absolutely sucks. Seriously, how many enemy fighters are here? What? Oh, finally! I suppose that would work as well. We can just disable things. Too bad these guys didn't jump in earlier. Oh, very nice. Subsystem destruction. So anything we can do is just like destroy its turrets and shit. Oh, it's got no subsystems. Oh, nice.
The primarily class fighter has been successfully brought here, and we are already working on refitting it for our purposes. The pilot is currently in custody, awaiting interrogation. As for the presence of the unknown fighters, designation D Hall, we have no intel on them. For their purpose, they may be an independently operating force with the same goal as us. We have no recommendations.
Wow, that was interesting.
Following the recent victory at Kepler Herculis, legionary forces have taken a noticeable hit. This should buy us some extra time to carry out the campaign. Your next mission will take place in the Helios system, in very low orbit around the local star. This mission will involve the Chimerally class fighter that we have captured last mission.
Oh, wonderful.
Scorpion 3 will be flying it. This is because an ADF-registered strike craft would immediately be recognized upon entering the area of operations.
Naturally.
At this altitude over the start, there are a set of communication satellites located not far from the Aether. The pirates were clever in positioning their communication lines here. It's a dangerous, remote location. Your main objective is to go into the field of engagement, approach each satellite and hack them. Don't worry if you failed computer science back in college. The process is automated and done over special equipment that's been fitted into your fighters.
Wonderful.
However, in order to establish a local connection, you need to stay within 200 m from the relay until hacking has finished. This process needs to be repeated about 3 times for the local relays, which are positioned about 8 clicks away from the Aether.
Wonderful.
However, despite the dangers of flying this close to a star, you will most likely find enemy patrols roaming the space between relays. They shouldn't engage you instantly, due to the brightness and radiation limiting visibility. Which means as long as you're 500 m away from the enemy, they will not see you. However, one thing to keep note of, do not, under any circumstances, fire your weapons if you wish to remain undetected. Firing your weapons will instantly alert the enemy to your position. Due to the radiation blocking outside communication, they will not be able to call for reinforcements. Engage at your discretion, but make sure not to stall for too long. Once you have had all three relays, return to the Antares jump node, from where you will jump to a pirate base with your new credentials. Hopefully they won't notice your disguise.
Hopefully.
The satellite relays are shielded against radiation, but your fighters are not. Once you're out there, it will only be a matter of time until the radiation starts damaging your subsystems.
Oh, wonderful.
Helios is a highly unstable star, frequently giving off very short but violent flares that will fry anything unshielded within its radius. That includes you. If mission control picks up an incoming solar flare, it will show up as a supernova timer on your HUD. By then, you better be done with the mission. You have approximately 5 minutes to complete your mission. make good use of that time.
5 minutes. So I have to hack all 3 satellite relays. Oh, wonderful. Oh, that's wonderful. I've got no shields at all. Man, this thing's afterburner sucks. Right, hacking in progress. Damn. Oh wow, I see what they mean. Damn, it's still damaging me. Wow. Yep, no support ship. Oh joy. As long as I just know which way it is, that's all I need. Okay, wait for them to go by. God, don't come this way, don't come this way, don't come this way. That's the right thing. Go away, go away, go away, go away, go away. Okay, hop over. Come on, 75%. Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. We can get the hell out of here. Okay, good. Satellite's all hacked. I should be able to technically leave. Maybe I have to go through here. There we go. Whew, that was a close call.
Excellent work, pilot. Our data team back at HQ has already modified your credentials to fool the pirates. This should make your espionage a whole lot easier.
Okay. To be honest, I'm not a fan of espionage missions. I really don't like them a lot. But let's see what we have to do.
You are now deep within enemy territory. The hat has worked. The pirates now believe you are one of them. Use this opportunity to gain as much information as possible, but make sure not to look too suspicious.
Oh, that's easy to do.
Welcome to the Legionary Carrier Aurora, pilot. One of the very few remaining operational Supremacy class supercarriers in Terran space. She's a relic, but still serves us well, and I hope you will do the same. The situation there back at Elidos was getting seriously problematic. Help, we lost one of our other carriers there while fleeing from an ADF attack. While the losses were getting very high, we're glad at least someone made it out alive.
Yeah, someone.
Speaking of losses, ever since ADF has set its sights on us, we've been taking very heavy casualties mission after mission. Our subordinate factions are starting to take us less seriously, and we've been losing influence ever since. But this will come to an end very soon. For now, we need to focus on improving the skills of our pilots, hence why we bought training simulators to use for this exact purpose. Head down to the simp rooms at 1755.
Yeah. Well, they seem quite well equipped, that's
this
for sure.
This scenario is simple. Two patrol fleets are pitted against the AK-3, one legionary and one ADF fleet. The sole objective is to destroy the enemy's carrier. It's a no-hold-barred battle, so use any means necessary in order to win. As for the discussion of tactics, I will leave you to your respective group leaders to discuss this. Alpha and Gamma, you will conduct hit and run attacks on hostile forces, drawing them to the Overlord forward black batteries. The more fighters we destroy, the higher our chances of success. Make sure not to get shot down though. Beta Wing, you will form the rear guard, defending the Overlord from any bomber wings trying to flank the Overlord's weak rear side. After the Aurora's supply of fighters has been exhausted, the Overlord will advance towards the enemy carrier and attack it with kinetic batteries and AP black barges. Due to the lack of defensive armament, if there are no fighters left to intercept, you can just sit back and watch the fireworks. That's all for the mission. Good luck.
Alright, so now we're going to be doing a simulated exercise. What do I get to fly as? Ooh, hello. The Star Fury. Aerostar Firefly. Okay, that's what I started with. Assault Fighter. It certainly ain't pretty though, but it looks like it's does its thing. Police Fighter. maneuverability bad. It's a multi-role fighter. Yeah, I think I'll stick with that. So, medium, low hull damage, high subsystem damage. Interesting. Interesting. Arrow and spear, okay. What's this? Oh, enforcer. Well, at least I got missiles to use, at least. General purpose interceptor missiles. Looks like the models are finished on this one. That's fine. Now let's see. Medium shield. Yeah, this one was low hull, medium shield. I need something that's high hull. Nah. That's the one. Alright, let's do this thing. Wow, these guys are actually putting up a bit of a fight. This, that's a carnage. Launch from the enemy's carrier. Wonderful. Ooh, lovely explosions. I love the fireworks. At least this way they can't launch any more fighters.
Congratulations, pilot. You have just witnessed the fruits of success of our greatest project yet. Of course, aside from the fact that the Nibhaunt has destroyed your carrier, you and your wing performed very well. I will negotiate with the higher UPS for promotion for your wing.
Higher UPS. So they now have beam cannon technology. Oh, that's just fucking great.
Scorpion 3, we have received the information about the unknown ship that the pirates have created. Your next objective is of utmost importance. At the next possible chance, you must scan each subsystem of the cruiser. Navigation, sensors, all that. On top of that, one of the standard turrets must be scanned, and then the big cannon on top. Scanning those things will automatically upload the data to our servers, so we can identify weak points and methods of destroying the ship. If the cruiser is in flight and not stationary, make use of Aya Mittal's flight ability Alt plus G and match speed. This should allow you to get a good look at it while not hitting anything. Once all six objects have been scanned, fly away from the Nibhaunt to engage your jump drive. The distance of at least 7,000 should suffice.
Ah, interesting.
Promotion Wolf 2, your performance during the last training session was truly astonishing, unlike anything we've seen with most of our pilots. As a result, you have been put in command of War Wing.
Oh no.
This promotion also comes with the opportunity to partake in the next mission, which is only for the elite of our fighters. Come to the briefing room at 15:35 for more details.
That should be interesting.
All right, listen up. The Nibhaunt battlecruiser has recently finished construction and is now fully operational. The first of its class. We have many more under construction in places elsewhere in our sphere of influence.
Oh.
She is the pride of our pirate force, reaching a milestone no pirate has ever reached before. Construct our very own class of Kali, and boy is she beautiful. Only the most skilled of fighters will go on this mission here, aside from the captain himself. You should consider yourself honored to be flying right next to the Nibhaunt now.
Nidhogg.
Now, our plan is to finally show her off to the world, to display our power, and that we are not a force to be trifled with. Cap's idea is that, using the Nibhaunt and other future Centurion ships, we can extort the authorities for protection money so we don't blow up their ships.
Always helpful.
But of course, first we have to get there. The Nibhaunt is currently in low orbital flight over Vega B. Vega being a relatively far out system, we can definitely expect those ADF pansies to show up.
No surprise.
Warlock Wing, you are to link up with the remaining escort wings, and make sure the Nibhaunt stays safe. Then stay with her until she jumps out. Simple as that. Shoot down anything or anyone that as much as tries to sneeze on the armor of the battlecruiser. Once the Nibhaunt has reached the Proxima Centauri node, you are to follow her through subspace. On site, you will most likely find one of the ADF's cruisers, if our intel is anything to go by. The Gladius. The Nibhaunt will take care of the Gladius. All you will have to do for that battle is shoot down enemy bombers, and other than that, just sit back and enjoy the fireworks.
Okay, so we need to scan the systems. Secondary objective, scan the Isanami. Can't change, okay. Alright, let's get to it. Come on, come on, come on.
I wish I could take this job, but it was either this or mining or inflation. No. With the highest death rate. Hey, not to break a mood here, but that's why I'm curious about the economy. No. Well, can you blame him? It is a nick ship after all. At least you have a choice. I want to during grade on my dad's trauma. Yeah, but something feels wrong. I'm glad I'm just a shipboard engineer. Not doing any shooting, just making sure the ship works. I'm sure if the accountants were listening to this conversation right now, we'd all get shocked on the spot.
Ah, shit. Man, this gliding thing is a pain in the ass. Ah, shit. Jeez Louise, man, come on. Hate these scanning missions that take 10 hours to do anything. See, I mean, though, the only thing I actually hate with these gliding on some of these games, though, they don't do the gliding very well. Come on. I'm gonna blow up my ship at this rate. There we go. Hopefully it can stay like this for a while. Come on, come on, don't fuck around. Good grief, come on. God, where are all the fighter bees in this stupid thing? There you are. Jeez Louise, what is wrong with this stupid ship? Oh, come on, let go. No. Come on, stop fucking around. Come on. Oh, so it has to be a specific cannon. Let's see. Whoa.
I won't let you get away. You will not leave here alive. Get that ECM online now.
Okay. Stand still. Whew. That was close.
You may have killed me, but the vault is already rolling. The meat hog will destroy all of you.
What? How did he survive? What? Whatever.
Scorpion 3, your mission is over. Return to base.
With 8% hit points intact.
Your efforts
like a boss.
Firing with specifications for the pirate battle cruiser are an immense step forward for all of us. Thanks to the data, we can now devise a plan of action against the Nibhaunt before it can deal any serious damage. Special commendations also go to you for defeating the accountant in subspace.
Yeah.
Stepping toe to toe against the leader of the pirates, you have persevered and struck him down. This is sure to set up the killing blow to the League. We have already moved all available assets to the Beta Cygni system in order to prepare a defense against the League of Dragons. You will take part in this mission as well.
Yeah, it seems simple enough.
We have no mathematical efforts in acquiring the specifications.
All right. Okay, that was interesting. Quite interesting, actually. So I think I'm going to pick this up a little bit later. But in the meantime, I hope all of you have enjoyed that. And I suppose we'll have to find out soon enough how things end up. A couple more missions left, I would say. So please remember, guys, like and subscribe. It really helps out the channel. And I'll see you in the next one.